The following cabaret may be offensive to conservatives. Viewer discretion is advised. Hello there, beautiful people of all genders and all persuasions out there in the ether, and welcome to episode 4 of Cabaret Virale. My name is Dusty Limits, and I am your host here in my somewhat upgraded night attire. Well, one does like to make an effort, doesn't one? And I am so delighted to be here with you this evening, or morning, or yesterday, or tomorrow, or what fucking day is it? Does anyone know anymore? Now, since you cannot come to the cabaret, we are bringing the cabaret to you. So I'm thrilled to be with you in your respective sitting rooms, dining rooms, bedrooms, conservatories, and sex dungeons. You know who you are. Now, lovely as it is to be in my palatial abode, I must admit, I do miss going out. I miss the pub, I miss the theatre, I miss dining in a restaurant. But nowadays, all restaurants are just like a song from Les Miserables. You know the one. Empty chairs at empty tables. Oh, come on, you got that. And my heart really does go out to all of you who are self-isolating completely on your own, because when you're alone and life is making you lonely, you've no place to go. Lockdown. Pause for laughter. Believe it or not, this is our fourth Cabaret Virale. I know, but when this whole thing started, I was determined to make the best possible use of the time that I felt had been gifted to me. So I immediately watched Schitt's Creek from start to finish 3 times in a row. Currently on my 4th viewing, who can blame me? Who are you to judge? Also, I threw in a little bit of time for masturbation. But enough about me, not that there ever is. Enough about me, let's hear from you. How are you doing down in the front row? Hello. And you up the back, how are you doing? Having a lovely time? A little bit less chit-chat, please. Thank you very much. Any more nonsense from you and I'll have you thrown out. Yes, I'm looking at you, Matt Hancock. Pause for laughter. As is traditional in cabaret, the first thing I want to do is a cheers, a little toast to all of you for coping thus far, and most of all to all of you doctors and nurses and carers and ancillary staff and cleaners and everyone else who has worked so hard and so bravely to keep the rest of us going. Cheers to you, I really mean it. I also want to raise a glass to those of you who think that the whole thing was a hoax or over-exaggerated, it's no worse than flu, and are therefore congregating and kissing each other and hugging each other and coughing all over each other and raising semi-literate placards in Hyde Park. I just want to raise a glass to say, goodbye. I doubt I'll be seeing you again. And let's all look forward to a future with cleaner air, kinder people, better government, and most importantly of all, no more fucking jokes about COVID-19. Yeah? Still, at least it's been a welcome respite from jokes about fucking Brexit, although you can expect them to reappear any time now. There will be more than one second wave. And I do hope when all this is over, we as a society will have developed a strong resistance to anything uttered by the government. I like to call it turd immunity. And now it's showtime, and what a show we have for you. We have music, we have burlesque, we have magic, we have storytelling. In short, we have anything you could possibly want on whatever day of the week this is. While I'm thinking of it, our final act this evening is very much NSFW, SFWN, whatever that damn acronym or whatever it is, nicht so kinderfreundlich. So if you're accustomed to watching the show with your family, you've been warned. You might have a lot of explaining to do. Once again, the rules of the show are simple. Please switch off your mobile phones. The world will still be here when you turn them back on again, I think. Number 2, please applaud when the prompt appears. We are artists, we can hear it even from the other side of the planet. And if you feel inclined to share the link to the show via your social media, go right ahead, knock yourself out. Do keep in mind this show is intended for an intelligent liberal audience who have an awareness of satire, a degree of whimsy, and are not offended by sheer vulgarity. Okay, Brilliant. And of course, the most important rule is rule number 3. If you've enjoyed what you see, or even if you haven't, please tip us, the artists, via the PayPal link, which I will provide in the credits, and also probably mention several times during the course of the evening. Okay, are we ready? In that case, I want to welcome to our stage a dear, dear old friend of mine, a wonderful singer and performer. She has a very big heart, and she always gives her all. And she has an awful lot of all to give. Please put your hands together and go crazy for the wonderful Sammy Mavis Jr.
Oh, hi, sorry. I was chatting to my good friend Dolly, who I've been self-isolating with. I'm not lonely. I'm Sammy Mavis Jr., and I am so excited to be performing for you live from my bedroom. And no, I did not think about the color scheme of the wall before I started this. Now, Dusty has asked us to perform in what we go to bed in. Now, those of you who know me well will know that I sleep commando, so I'm afraid I'm just in a simple romper suit here. But I hope you'll forgive me and imagine me naked when you go to sleep tonight. So, I have a serious message. I want to say a thank you, because there are people out there who are doing so much work to help us. There are people out there who, for the first time in their lives, are picking up musical instruments and learning to play them. And I think that is so beautiful to see. I mean, it's not beautiful to hear, but it is so beautiful to see. And in the spirit of that, I wanted to sing a song, which I wrote. And there is going to be some live playing on it. But I have to say, I will not be playing because I am not skilled enough. The instrument of choice. Well, some of you may have never even seen one of these before, so this could be quite a big encounter. This is a very rare instrument called an ukulele. Now, I borrowed this from my friend Kasia. You know Kasia, Kasia from Poland. She came here to work in the sex industry, but when she got here, all the jobs were taken. So sadly, she had to fall back on being a primary school teacher. But she's given us this beautiful instrument. And actually, Dolly, would you? You would? Oh, Dolly is gonna play for us. Thank you so much, Dolly. Let's just rest that there. Wow, let's see, is it in tune? Great. Okay, Dolly, just sit up there now. This is your big moment. So Dolly and I are gonna sing for you, and I'll just switch on the microphone, and this is a song dedicated to all of you who are self-isolating in couples. That's right, you can self-isolate as a couple, but please, please be sensible. This song is for you. Are you okay, sweetie? Are you all right? Don't flash your money shot. We haven't been paid enough for that yet. Okay, great. All right, lovely. If you love me, keep your distance. If you want me, stay away. And if you're needing my assistance, I'll text you over some foreplay. If you love me, you can zoom me. I'll even turn the volume on. I might let you back in front room me. 2 meter distance or I'm gone. Baby, you're so hot, but I don't want what you've got. Keep it out of sight, we can make it last all night. If you love me, write a letter. Come on, Dolly. Slip it underneath the door. Your hands before, then sanitize the bedroom floor. When you're not here, I want you more. Tomorrow, let's try semaphore. Oh, well done, Dolly. Well done. And you have a great time wherever you are. Please remember, don't go outside unless you really have to. And if anyone knows where to get flour, I will sleep with you.
Wasn't that wonderful? Thank you so much, Sammy Mavis Jr. Our next guest was one of the stars of our very first Cabaret Virale. He did things on a bed that could scarcely be imagined. He returns to take us all down, drag us, you might say, all down into a deep, dark, dangerous, and delicious world God, I love alliteration. Anyway, please join me in welcoming to our virtual stage the very, very exciting Sebastian Angelique!
If you're happy and you know it, wiggle your ears. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, wiggle your ears. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet.
Stomp your feet.
If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet.
Stomp your feet.
If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray.
Shout hooray.
If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray.
Shout hooray.
If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy.
I'm the bad guy.
Thank you, Sebastian. That was hot. Or is it just this weather and my synthetic fibre caftan? Who knows? Oh, are you having a lovely time? I've got to check in with you. Giving you all a big wave? I can see it using my mind. Okay, so here we go. Our next guest is another one of the alumni of episode one of Cabaret Virale. She is a raconteuse par excellence, the absolutely enchanting Ada Camp.
Hello, my friends. It's Ada Camp here. I hope you're keeping well, darlings, and healthy, managing to get all the food you need. I long for eggs and flour, but I'm just consisting on pretty much chocolate digestives, pineapple juice, and supermarket white wine. But there we are. I am having the most extraordinary, vivid dreams every night and rather enjoying them. Are you dreaming, my friends? I do hope so. Extraordinary what the mind gets up to, isn't it? I had a dream last night of one of the most extraordinary special acts I've ever seen in my life. I'd almost quite forgotten about him. I'm rather grateful to the goddesses of dream, whoever and wherever they may be. This young man I first met in a theatre somewhere, I don't remember where, East Anglia perhaps, or South Wales, or Billingham. But I do remember him. I remember seeing him sitting on a sofa in the green room. He had very dark eyes, very high cheekbones, very pale gums. He was keeping himself to himself, rather, so I asked after him, and I was told that he had come from a well-to-do family, but he had run away as a teenager when they discovered he was of a theatrical bent. He ran all the way to Paris, where he trained under that great French variety artiste, Le Grand Legume. When I met him in that little theatre, wherever it was, he was working under the name Vegetary Allen, and he did one of the most extraordinary things I've ever seen to this day. He would walk up and down the aisles of the auditorium during the show, my friend, wearing soft-soled shoes, a long Fagin-like coat, and an enigmatic smile, silently and discreetly appearing vegetables at seemingly random moments. Imagine, if you will, that you are sat in the stalls, peering up at the spectacle before you. Suddenly, you catch a whiff of some very elegant French cologne. Turning your nose towards the scent, you would see nothing. But when you looked back, there would be a broccoli floret between your thighs. Wonderful stuff! And it wasn't just the stalls. No, no! You might be in the upper circle, in the cheap seats, peering down at the spectacle beneath. Suddenly, you would become aware of a spotlight beam glancing off a pair of very high cheekbones. Turning your head towards that light, you would see nothing. But when you looked back, there would be a row of Brussels sprouts on the safety rail in front of you. Magnificent stuff! If you're not impressed with that, my friends, you should be. This was in the days before we had near 24-hour access to fresh fruit and vegetables, or even people willing to deliver substitute ones to us at all times of the day and night. Some people in the north had never seen anything like it. They didn't even think then of vegetables as entertainment. Imagine that. Poof. I know. I don't know what happened to him, but I urge you next time you're picking up a glass of something slightly alcoholic or not alcoholic at all, just next time you're picking up a glass or a mug. Beggars can't be choosers, we're all stuck at home. A mug would be fine to raise it to Vegetary Allen, wherever he may be. I am delighted that he visited me in my dream last night. Well, my friends, I think... What's this? you there? How extraordinary. Ooh. Ooh. What am I to do with these? What would you have me do? I'll get back to you. Have a good day. The beans are leading me onwards. What fun to lose.
Thank you, Ada. That was gorgeous. Now, this is obviously a time of transformation, and I do hope that when it's all over, those of us who are still breathing will emerge from this crisis like a butterfly from a chrysalis. Or even a chrysalis. Pause for laughter. So now to inspire you, I present you with the magnificent Oliver Tabor and Vicky Butterfly.
Thank you.
Okay, so it was an egg, but you do take my point. All I want is egg. Do, 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 do. Please do not make me beg. Do, 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 do. Anyway, this brings us to our final gorgeous guest this evening for Cabaret Virale episode 4. I should warn you in advance, if you are troubled by strong language, avert your ears. Now might be the time to go and make yourself a cup of something warming. Our next guest comes to us all the way from New York, the city that never sleeps, mostly because it's completely infested with bed bugs. But she's a wonderful old friend, a brilliant singer, and this is the educational portion of this evening's programme. So please, slap your palms together with great vigour and enthusiasm for the gorgeous Sabrina Chapp!
Hey everyone, it's Sabrina Chapp, and I am here to sing you a wonderful sexy song while wearing my pajamas. Do you like them? This is what I really wear when I'm going to sleep with my teddy bear from when I was born. His name is Poncho. But of course, when I go to sleep at home, I'm actually always wearing this. This is sort of my nighttime look at home. I thought that I would put it on while I'm singing you this song. So basically, I'm spending a lot of my time teaching children from home on Zoom, which is something that people let me do. But at the same time, I'm not getting laid. So these two things, they've sort of come into one strange little amalgamation of a song that I'd like to sing for you right now. So this is going to educate you, not only in terms of your alphabet, but also in terms of how you're going to get fucked once this is all over. Are you ready? Yeah! So this is audience participation. So when I say, are you ready? You go, yeah! Ready? Are you ready? I'm totally sure you did that. Okay, and I'm going to be asking for you guys to sing out during the song. So let's see if you guys do it. A is for my asshole, it's a thing that you can lick. B is for blowjob, a lovely party trick. C is for my cunt, let's see how much you can fit. And everybody say it. D is for... Did you get dick? The answer was dick. Alright, let's all scare your neighbors. D is for... Yeah, dick. Good job. Here we go. Ejaculation, it's a thing that you can do. For women, it comes out in spurts. For men, it comes in goo. F is for fucking, my favorite thing to do. Just try and hit my G-spot and I'll come all over you. An education, we must be literate but fuck well as a nation. From anal fucking to masturbation, an education is what this country needs, right? Yeah, I think so. H is for horny, when you are hard and red, and you will take most anyone you see into your bed. I is for insertion, don't just use the head, ram it in and ram it hard, it helps if they are spread. It does, ha! The letter J is for jerking off, now try and understand, it's when you take your pleasure into your own hands, and while you're jerking off you think of amputees or plants. Some people do, it's fine. K is for kinky, it's a lifestyle in your pants. An education, we must be literate but fuck well as a nation. And from anal fucking to masturbation, an education is what this country fucking needs, don't you think? Yeah! Alright, now I would like to ask the people at home right now, what letter are we on? Are you thinking to yourself, I should have been paying attention? Or are you finally cognizant of the fact that you don't fucking know your alphabet? All right, well, you know what? I'm just going to help you out. We are at, let's see, I don't know, H-I-J-K-L, L, L, we're at L. So I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, and you're all going to yell L. 1, 2, 3! That wasn't bad, but I think we should scare your neighbors with it. And then after L comes... M, yeah, you nailed that one. And then... N. So, you're gonna say the rest of the alphabet, and hopefully you're drunk enough to do it. So let's try with L first. 1, 2, 3! L is for labia, that loose meat by your clit. M, masturbation, muffer masochist. N, nymphomania, insatiable delight. O is for orgasm when they get it just right. P is for pussy, my pussy needs relief. Q, when it sneezes, that is called a queef. R is for rim job, please don't use your teeth. S, all the sadists have a different belief. T, titties, tit winking, testicles, or twat. U, all the sound when you like it.
V is for vulva, a place to put your face. W, everyone, you deserve a wank. X-rated movies simply are the best. Y, the sexiest of words. Yes, yes, yes. Zeds are what you catch as you drift off into sleep. After someone's fucked you, really fucking deep. And now you're wet and dripping, and now your dreams are sweet. Tomorrow, do it all again, just try and change the sheets. And education, we must be literate, but fuck well as a nation. And batteries can add vibration, and education is what this country needs.
Thank you, Sabrina. I learned a lot from that song, and it's inspired me to end this evening's proceedings with a song of my own composition. If you've been paying attention to the news lately, and I hope you have, you'll understand where this song is coming from. I felt that the nation needed a clear, simple, direct message they could understand, not some silly, vacuous slogan that makes no sense to anybody. And that's what this is. And also, it's a sing-along. Your lyrics are the words, or both. So after me, or both. Well done. Sing out, Louise. Now, I know I did promise that under no circumstances during this lockdown would I learn the ukulele, but I have kept that promise. I absolutely haven't done that. What I have done is found this magical, invisible bingo-lele. Ah, isn't it nice? I'm just going to tune it up now, and then I'm going to sing you this song. Full confession, there were moments in the composition of this song where I felt it was maybe a little bit simplistic or cheap or just plain nasty. But having been paying attention to the news, I've realised it's not nearly nasty enough. If you vote a Tory, you're a moron or a twat. A moron or a twat. Oh, really? Fancy that. If you vote a Tory, you're a moron or a twat. A moron or a twat. Or both. If you vote a Tory, you're an arsehole or a prick. An arsehole or a prick. And really pretty thick. If you vote a Tory, you're an arsehole or a prick. You're an arsehole or a prick, or both. Well, I know that you don't want to hear this, and normally I'm live and let live. But telling the truth can be sheer bliss, and here are the fucks that I give. So, if you vote a Tory, you are stupid or you're vile. You're stupid or you're vile, and you're clearly in denial. And if you vote a Tory, you are stupid or you're vile. You are stupid or you're vile, or both. And if you vote a Tory, well, I don't want to be blunt, but you're a selfish cunt. And on that cheerful note, that's the end of the show. I hope you enjoyed it. I really don't care if you didn't. I can't actually see you. Please do follow the artists. You'll find their social media handles in the credits at the end. Please do share the link with all your friends and indeed with your enemies. They might enjoy it. And please, most importantly of all, do tip the artists. Every penny that you donate to our PayPal is split evenly between all members of the company for this show. So here's the hat speech. How much would you have spent on a glass of wine, were you allowed to go and drink wine in a pub, or a flat white coffee if you're that way inclined, or I don't know, a second-hand car, or a socially distanced Reiki massage, or I don't know, having someone killed? Because the thought has occurred to me. Well, pick that number, double it, and pop it in our PayPal. And now, sad moment. I'm not sure whether there will be an episode 5 of Cabaret Virale. I really love doing this show. I really love working with all these gorgeous artists, and I hope you've enjoyed what we've done. The simple fact is, this hopefully will be obsolete in, you know, due course. So if I don't see you again, thank you for joining us all. I really do appreciate it. But you never know, the second wave is on its way. Lockdown! Cheers. I'm Dusty Limits. Good night.